Hi dear friends, good morning. I am happy to stand before you today to explain the accounting rules with examples. Before that, I like to place a request before all of you. If you are watching my video for the first time, you may not be familiar with my pronunciation. So I request you to activate the CC icon available in this video. See, please touch the video, then you will get the CC icon, activate it, then you will get the script of my lecture also. See, then I am going to teach you the accounting rules with examples, and number of this video is R5. This is the continuation of the video R4. Let's see, example number 4. Paul bought machinery from David for the business for rupees 1,50,000 and an advance of rupees 25,000 is given in cash. See, once again, Paul bought machinery from David for rupees 1,50,000 and an advance amount of 25,000 is given. That is, balance is to be paid. Then, standard pattern for analyzing our transaction is identify the two accounts and apply the Grida formula to both the accounts. Here in this example, instead of two accounts, there are three affected accounts. We will come across three affected accounts. Think from the viewpoint of the business. Bought machinery for 1,50,000. Paid cash 25,000. Balance credit given by David 1,25,000. Here, business didn't pay 1,25,000. It is to be paid to David later. That means 1,25,000 owes to David. Therefore, David is a creditor of the business for rupees 1,25,000. Here the affected accounts are machinery 1,50,000, cash 25,000, and David's account 1,25,000. Let's take all the three accounts one by one and apply the Grida formula. First, machinery. Grida, group, rule, increase or decrease, apply. See, group. Machinery is an asset, therefore it falls under group number 1. Then, rule. Rule of group number 1 is increase debited, decrease credited. Then, here increase or decrease. Machinery came into the business, value of machinery increased. Then apply. Value of machinery increased, rule is increase debited. Therefore, machinery account is to be debited for rupees 1,50,000. Then the next account. Cash account 25,000. Grida, group, rule, increase or decrease, apply. Group. Cash is an asset. Therefore, it falls under group number 1. Then rule. Rule of group number 1 is increase debited, decrease credited. Then here increase or decrease. Cash 25,000 went out of business. Therefore, cash decreased. Then apply. Cash decreased. Rule is decrease credited. Therefore, cash account is to be credited for rupees 25,000. Then take the third account. David's account for 1,25,000. Grida, group, rule, increase or decrease, apply. Group. David's account. Business has to pay 1,25,000 to David. Therefore, David is a creditor or liability to the business. Therefore, David's account falls under group number 2. Then rule. Rule of group number 2 is increase credited, decrease debited. Then here increase or decrease. Here a new liability, David's account arose. Therefore, David's account increased. Then apply. David's account increased. Rule is increase credited. Therefore, David's account is to be credited for ₹1,25,000. Then we will get the journal entry. Machinery account debtor ₹1,50,000. To cash account ₹25,000. To David's account ₹1,25,000. Then take example number 5. Goods purchased from Sunil Traders ₹50,000. Standard pattern is identify the two affected accounts and apply the GRIDA formula to both the accounts. Think from the viewpoint of the business. Goods came into the business. Here, there is no mention as to the payment of cash. At the same time, supplier's name is specifically stated here, that is Sunil Traders. Because of these 2 points, we can assume that this transaction is a credit transaction. Therefore, 2 affected accounts are goods account and Sunil Traders account. In every business, there might be purchases of goods as well as sale of goods. In order to distinguish between these purchases and sales, we can rename goods here as purchases. Therefore, the 2 affected accounts are purchases account and Sunil Traders account. Let us take the 2 accounts one by one and apply the GRIDA formula. First, purchases account, 50,000. GRIDA, group, rule, increase or decrease, apply. Group. Purchases here means goods. And if goods are kept in the business as stock, it will come under the heading asset. On the other hand, if it is used in the business in the current year itself, it will come under the head expenses. In both the cases, purchases will fall under group number 1. Rule of group number 1 is increase debited, decrease credited. Here increase or decrease, goods came into the business. Therefore, value of purchases increased. Then apply. Here value of purchases increased. Rule is increase debited. Therefore, purchases account is to be debited for 50,000. Then take Sunil Traders account. See GRIDA, group, rule, increase or decrease, apply. Group. Sunil Traders account. Business has to pay 50,000 to Sunil Traders account. Therefore, Sunil Trader is a creditor or liability to the business. Therefore, Sunil Trader's account falls under group number 2. Then, rule. Rule of group number 2 is increase credited and decrease debited. Then, here increase or decrease. Here a new liability is Sunil Trader's account arose. Therefore, Sunil Traders account increased. Then apply. Sunil Traders account increased. Rule is increase credited, and therefore Sunil Traders account is to be credited 4,50,000. Then we will get the journal entry. Purchases account debtor 50,000 to Sunil Traders account 50,000. Dear friends, I conclude. I hope that all of you enjoyed this presentation. Please be kind enough to note down your comments in the comment box. Please be kind enough to subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching. Bye and see you again.